بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد Among the أعمال of نبوت is the عمل of دعاء دعاء is a means of drawing from the unlimited treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala بقول من فاروق صاب Even a stingy person who has limited resources When a beggar comes to him, he begs so much, even if he doesn't want to give, he still gives just to get rid of the beggar. Whereas we are asking Allah, who is Wahhab, Razzaq, Al-Mu'ti, Al-Nafi', the one that wants benefit, that's a giver, the generous, the sustainer. The one whose treasures are unlimited and whose resources are vast beyond comprehension. And you think so, Allah will not give you. So we have to recognize Allah when a person has yaqeen in the Zat of Allah and has yaqeen in the treasures of Allah, then they will turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, they will turn to the creation. So a person can understand who Khaliq is, somebody who is wealthy and gives generously, will say he's such a generous person. But compared to somebody who is more richer and more generous, this first person will seem to be stingy. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the King of Kings, the generous of the most generous, Ajwad Man Su'il. أَوْسَعُ مَنْ أَعْطَى The most generous of all generous and the one whose treasures are most vast. So dua is asking, taking اپنی حاجت کو بلند بارگاہ میں پیش پیش کرنا یہ دل کی کیفیت ہے that you need to place it in front of a superior being is called dua. And it's a condition of the heart. Manasin Khan Sahib, you say we don't make dua anymore. We do not make dua anymore. All we do is say words. So we are not making dua anymore. We are just repeating words. Dua is a kayfiyat of the heart. And the greater the need, the more a person will beg. Like a person who is going to lose their life or their loved one is going to be killed and they have to beg for their life or the loved one's life. How does this person beg? We need to understand that our need will not be fulfilled by the makhluk, by the khaliq. And the greatest need is the need to find Allah. The greatest need is to find our direction in life and get hidayat. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. So when a person doesn't understand the need and who will fulfill needs, then our attention will go to makhluk, like was discussed in the chapters of yaqeen. A person has a financial problem, he'll go to the bank manager or his wealthy friend. A person is ill, he'll go to the doctor or surgeon or medication. A person has legal problems, he will go to the lawyer and attorneys. A person has monetary issues, monetary benefit, but he's looking for monetary benefit, where does he go? Medical benefit, where does he go? More important than all these benefits, whether it's medical, whether it's financial, whether it's physical, whether it's mental, whether it's psychological, we need to understand the solution to our problems lies only in Allah's hands. Sahaba had any need, whether it was food, they turned to Allah, whether it was water, they turned to Allah. Whether they needed rain, they made dua. Whether they needed to bring the dead alive, they turned to Allah. and submitted to Allah in dua. The solution lies only in Allah's hands. Allah is the sustainer. This comes from Him. If a person thinks our needs are fulfilled by anyone else, Mawlana Musa Palanpuri used to give the example. He said, you have a tank and you have one tap. Put another tap. Put a third tap. If it's a 100-liter tank, no matter how many taps you put in it, you're still going to get the same amount of water. So dunya and the people of dunya's resources are limited. The resources of Allah is unlimited. A person understands. A trader, a businessman understands his needs are fulfilled through the shop. But the shop has a limited capacity. The shop has a lifeline. There's a timeline. The business sector is in has a lifeline. It is all connected to asbab and means. Whereas we need to connect ourselves through Allah. Maulana Ismail used to say, Har aadmi ke andar mangne kamada hai. Each person has a natural disposition to ask. It's intrinsic. It is natural. Agar Allah se lega to wo dua hai. This capacity, if we ask Allah, it is called dua, or wo ghair mahdood hai. And that treasure, the giver, his treasure is unlimited. And if you ask the creation, he said it is su'al or su'al haram hai. It is begging. And begging is forbidden in Islam. And if you desire in the heart, you should say it's ishraf, it's asking from the heart. He said that's makruh. So you say aaj sual al ishraf ne dua ko barbad kiya. Thus asking with the tongue to the creation and desiring from the creation with our hearts has destroyed the power of dua. So, an ordinary businessman stands in his shop for 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 12. Some people have 14-hour shifts daily. Some work 5 days a week, some 6, some 7. 24-7, 7, 11, 8 till late. Work till you drop. We've understood so much hours need to be given to acquire a measle, an insignificant portion of dunya. How come we have not understood to acquire the best of dunya in akhirat? We need to give a lot of hours, not a little seconds. Time is given nowadays for dua for a few seconds. And Baghawan Zaid Khan Sahib, we are just saying words. It's not the inner kayfiyat of the heart. The Mashayikh say the sign that dua is accepted is that a person reaches that kayfiyat in condition that they don't want to leave making dua. They feel it difficult and a burden to stop making dua. Like a person who's in front of a king, and the king says, ask what you want. Ask what you want. When you know what treasure the king has, you won't want to stop asking until you get your needs fulfilled. Until I don't get my work done, I will not stop. The ulama say, a person who does not spend a lot of time in dua, that's a sign of Iblis, Shaitan, and a sign of a mutakabbir. He is a proud and arrogant person. Because a proud person will say, why should I ask him? Who is he? So a person who does not understand that he is needy and he has to place his need in front of the one that fulfills his needs, this is a mutakabbir. So we need to learn dua. If a person does not learn dua, then he will become a slave of the people of the dunya. And if he learns dua, he'll become the slave of Allah. So, in the time of Maulana Yusuf Rahmatullah Alayhi, when Maulana Ilyas passed away, then people said that now Maulana Ilyas has departed, and now what are you going to do to fulfill the requirements of the Marakis, etc. So he smiled. He said, Dene wale ke haath nahi badla, sirf lene wale. The hand of the taker has changed, not the giver. The one that is giving Allah, his hand has not changed. Just the taker, the receiver, the recipient, his hand has changed. So our focus, our attention should go to Allah in any situation. أَمَّ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرِ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. In Tafsir Uthmani and this ayah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting the one who is in need. He said, like how in external means we've understood to solve our problems with asbab, in external forms, apparent forms, dua bhi ek sabab hai. Dua is also a means. We've not understood it. I've understood, I've got a problem. If I go to Mr. X, my problem will be solved. I've got a headache. If I take medication, my headache will dissipate. We've understood those as asbab. I've not understood if I do amal, if I turn to Allah, then my headache will be cured. So Abdullah Sahab used to explain, he says, until we don't lose hope in everything, a person will not turn to Allah. Madad aati hai jab aadmi charo taraf mayus hoti. When a person loses hope in all four directions, we have to lose complete hope in the creation. The same one used to say that one of the objects of tabligh is quwwat-e dua ko qaim karna hai, to establish, to increase the strength of dua. And that's why Mashaikh say zarurat ke waqt jahan zehn jaate hai usko yakin kehte hai. At the time of need, where your heart and mind goes to, that is called yakin. So a child is going to the supermarket, to the bazaar, he's at the store and he's got a whole list. Somebody laughs at him and he said, you know, you've got no money on you. How are you going to buy all these things? He said, you didn't see my father in the other aisle. Didn't you see my father? A small child knows that his father is with him, he will fulfill his needs. How come intelligent people like us don't know that Allah Rabbul Alameen is with us and Allah will fulfill our needs? So in Arabic, da'a yad'u, Arabic du'a is a mustard, and ulama have explained istid'a'ul abdi rabbahu, that seeking, beseeching Allah for your needs and your necessities. Idharul iftiqar ilayhi, displaying your necessity in front of Allah and absolving the entire creation from fulfilling any of your requirements is called dua, and that is a form of ibadah and worship. Ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah, or kama qal. That dua is ibadah in itself. Actually, it's amongst afdalul ibadah, the most virtuous forms of ibadah. So making dua, besides fulfilling our needs and requirements, is considered a great form of worship, like Al-Hajj wa Arafah. The greatest part of Hajj is in wukuf of Arafah. So the Hajj constitutes different amal and actions. But a primary, a focal point of Hajj is Arafah. Likewise, a focal and a primary factor for an abid is dua. So the ulama have discussed that a person makes dua. So different riwayat, Qadr Allah al-Maqadir, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had predestined destiny before the creation, بكذا وكذا عاما جف القلم بما هو كائن, the ink has dried up. So taqdeer it in its place. And then other riwayat, الدُّعاء واجب وهو يدفع البلاء ويرد القضاء, that dua can remove calamities and hardships, and it can change destiny. لا يرد القضاء لا يرد القدر إلا الدعاء. So different narrations of changing taqdeer. And then أن الدعاء والقضاء يلتقيان, that dua and taqdeer meet in the heavens, between earth and the sky, and they vie with each other. So combining all these narrations, the ulama have given different explanations. One where they say it doesn't affect, which is a facet, an unacceptable explanation. Secondly, it will change taqdeer. Thirdly, when it is according to taqdeer, then it will be accepted. And the fourth one, that this is written in a person's taqdeer, that when dua is made at this juncture, it will change the course of his taqdeer. So the ulama have given different explanations. Say like Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, Allah created Jannat and Jahannam. Sahaba inquired that people will become lax if they know people will go to Jannat or Jahannam. He said, no. فَكُلُّ مُيَسَّرْ لِمَا خُلِقَ لَهُ, whatever you've been created for, it'll be easy for you. The sign that you are doing the amal of Jannat should be a consolation. So carry on striving, because this is a landmark, it is a sign, it is a flag. So other explanations where a person, his life, فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ لَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ, your life cannot be increased. But when a person makes khidmah of his parents, then he will have an increase in life. Increase in one, ulama explained, barakah. Secondly, it will change taqdeer. So that is written in taqdeer. Likewise, risk. وَيَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ, that Allah will give you risk without hisab kitab. So now a person, what is written in risk and in taqdeer, if you do that action, then your destiny will change. So we should not become beggars. If we have to become beggars, we become beggars of Allah. You see, there was a king, he was waving to his loyal subjects from the steps of the palace when he spotted a beggar in the crowd, was in rags and shams, but he looked like the king. So he called a guard, summoned him and told, bring the beggar. And the crowd was amazed of the resemblance. So the king was amused at somebody that looks like me. And he said, tell me, my good friend, smiling, was your mother perhaps a servant of the royal palace? Was your mother perhaps a servant of the royal palace? So the beggar replied, no, your highness. My father was a beggar of the palace. So, as the quote goes, you cannot keep your head high as long as your hands are lowered. Kings don't beg, they rule, decree, distribute. We are kings, we are not servants, and we got Malikul Muluk. So the amal for today is to make dua and to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.